everybody, it's Natalia from My New Bell Mode. I hope you're doing great. I am here today to show you a couple different ways to wear your hair for the rainy season. I don't know what weather is like other parts of the world. Right now I'm in France, and where we are, we're on the west coast of France. We're about 20 minutes from the Bay of Biscay, I totally forgot, which is like the big bay that goes between Spain and France. It rains quite a bit here in the fall and winter and spring. It rains quite a bit. And I'm from California where it's super dry all the time, and yeah, I don't know which I prefer. Sun. I prefer the sun. Anyways, the weather in here is okay, but lately it's been raining a lot, so I thought it would be fun to do a tutorial just to show you guys a couple different ways to wear your hair when it rains. Super practical, right? And because I want to keep it real with you, this is my rainy day hair. Yep. What happened is I curled my hair all nice the other day. No, it was the next day. So I curled my hair, and then the next morning my kids wanted to take their bikes to school, so I obliged, and it was raining. So, not downpour, but whatever, sprinkles on my hair, and it messed up the curl, and now it's a big hot mess. Really curl wherever it wants to be, and blah, blah, blah. So, anyways, I thought today would be a perfect day to show you. I have real hair that was in the rain. It's a couple days old, a day or two old, I think, so a little bit of grease, a little bit of grunge, but you know, I mean, that adds to hairstyles, doesn't it? So, I just, let's take it from here. Let's start. Okay, let's get started with the easy one. First, we're going to give some height on top, starting up here. So, as you can see, my hair is a pretty big hot mess. I have product in it from when I did it the other day. So, I also neglected to tell you guys that I have not brushed my hair since I curled it 2 days ago. So, I just am keeping it real today, guys. This is real. Now that we have some volume on top, keep that volume. Mess is good. We're going to go with the mess because when you're in the rain, you can't control the frizz and the mess that comes with it. So you're going to keep that top on top. I am going to do a wrap around top knot because I just want to show you, an idea. In my opinion, it's best to keep the rest of your hair, this part, tucked. Actually, you know, ponytail's not bad, but anyways, tucked away and stuff like that, so keep the style all day. I'm not even gonna tease it. I'm gonna wrap it around, flatten it out, and pin. Messy is good. So I have a little bit of a messy bun on top where I just wrapped it around and pinned it. Nothing special. Then you can take any kind of headband you want. I'm taking a crocheted fashion headband by my friend Paige from Paige in a Blanket, is the name of her shop. I'm gonna gently put it over, which you totally could have done this actually before you made the bun. And lightly put it where you want it. Headband. Really to add to the just to add to the style, not so much because it's holding anything back. It's more of a fashion statement type thing. So there you go. I like the contrast of this one in my hair. I like that it's pretty and feminine with a messy bun, you know, kind of contrast. And that's it for hairstyle number one. Okay. Number two, you're gonna love it. It is beyond easy. Watch, set your timer, under 2 minutes. Except for that I talk too much. Anyways, all up, keep that tease that we had from the last one. If this is your first time doing the hairstyle, obviously you can tease. Wrap your ponytail, pull it out. Ow! Okay, pull it out gently. Now, create the hole. Push your hair through the hole. Then pull it out. Until you have a nice, pretty bun on top. all I did was pull out the top so it's like even all around. What is my deal? Okay, so that it's even all around, because when you do these top T ponytails, sometimes they can get uneven. And then if you have these, couple options, you can leave them. I'm going to separate them, twist over, and pin them under. Super easy. Did you tag me? Was it under 2 minutes? And you got like a really pretty, like twisty, turvy thing going on here. You got the bun up top. Super easy. Hair out of your face. Perfect for rainy days. That was hairstyle number 2. Okay, hairstyle number 3. We are going to go ahead and take, you're gonna just need bobby pins for this one. Basically, that's it. So you're gonna go however way you wanna part your hair. I'm gonna use the volume that we already have in it just from being messy and from the teeth that we just did. And then you're gonna go ahead and take right behind the ears, straight back. Excuse me, big chunk of hair. Ah, like I said, I haven't brushed my hair in a few days. Dealing with some mess. Okay, so once we have it here, you can tease out to make it even. Mine's not very even right now, and I'm just gonna go with it.
Okay, I wanted to do a voiceover so you guys could, so I could better explain it. So basically, it is a knotted French braid. I started at the top and I'm taking 3 different sections. The first section, you just tie in a regular knot with your hair. And then, like a French braid, the second section, you'll pick up 2 big chunks from either side and tie the knot. What's important to see or know or whatever is that every time you tie the knot, whichever way you go, the other knot needs to go the opposite way so that the bumps aren't showing in a particular, like all on one side. So in this case, yeah, like over, under, and then the next one's under, over. So the 3 main knots, which are the 3 sections that you just did, are the ones that matter the most. And then afterwards, you're just gonna continue tying knots all the way down your hair till you get to the very end.
Okay, now you have knots down your hair. What I'm gonna do is kind of like a pretty little thing. I'm just gonna tuck that under. And you're going to have, pin it. Now you have like a knotted hairstyle on the back. So I'm just gonna do actually a simple twist. And I'm going to tuck it right in here on the side. Into where the knot is, right here. And there you go. Super simple knotted bun. Okay, hairstyle number 4, super easy. We're gonna do a big side part. Take up here and braid. Just a regular French braid, so we're gonna take.
Okay, so I sped this up pretty fast just because I didn't want the video to be like 20 minutes long. But I wanted to do this voiceover to let you know that what I'm doing here is I'm pulling pieces from the outside of where my hair is. As you can see, like I'm pulling all the way back and into the braid. What I think this does is it makes the braid a little bit more piecey, and it helps you like when you're pulling it out to make it wider and prettier and look bigger and more luscious. So even if you have thin hair, this is totally doable to make your braid look big and sexy, like Rapunzel type hair.
Okay, braids are a great option for rainy days, because as you can see, it gets it all out of your face and contained. I don't have a tiny rubber band, but a tiny rubber band would be better. And I wear it everywhere. Okay, from here, I mean, unless you like the really tight look, it's fun to just pull it out. There you go. So as you can see, once you pull it out, it looks big and beautiful, and this kind of slags a little bit, and then the back it just sweeps across and then down into your braid. But basically your hair is all contained and ready to brave the rain. I find that it's a good option for me anyways. So I can see this little hair skin. This is a big side French braid, and I think that it's perfect for the rain. Perfect for rainy days. So, if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, I'd really appreciate it. And if you feel so inclined, go ahead and subscribe, I'd love to have you. And other than that, I hope you guys have a fabulous day, and if it's raining where you are, try one of these styles, snap a picture, and tag me in it. I'll leave my social links below so that you can do that. I love to see when people try styles that I've put out there, so I would really love to hear about it. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day.